Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about comparing the data in spreadsheets. We have a tool called DATADECODER in which one of the utility is comparing the spreadsheets data. So here is the second link, and you can see the details of on how to compare the data present in spreadsheets from datadecoder.blogspot.in, and here is the link compare spreadsheet data. Data in tool spreadsheets. So let's take one example of comparing the data in spreadsheets. Here you can see this example has a list of employee IDs along with the details. So we have employee ID, name, department, phone, and email. The same way in this data we have employee ID as the unique identification column. So each employee ID will be distinct, the names, the corresponding names, and the department which they belong to, the phone and the email. So the same the similar kind of data we have exist in green data set. So the yellow data, so the intention is we need to compare the data in yellow with the data in green using the unique key, which is the employee in this case. Let's run the DATADECODER spreadsheet comparison script. So you can download the DATADECODER spreadsheet comparison script from datadecoder.blogspot.in, and once you download it, here you see this is the downloaded file, downloaded folder, and you see two scripts and two input files. So the first input file, the file one, will have all the data plus the copied from the Excel sheet. The yellow colored cells are directly copied and pasted. I'm just pasting it again so you can understand it. Save it and close. The second data set, which is marked in green color, take it, just copy and open file to save. Let's close it. Okay, now we have the first data set, which is marked in yellow in file one, the second data set, which is marked in green, file two. Now, we will compare the data between the yellow and the green data sets by taking the yellow data set as the reference. So we have five columns. You see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and employee ID is the unique ID. So let's start running the script. Double click it. The initial input is how many number of columns we have. We have five columns, and enter the primary key column position. Here in this case, if we say primary key column, it is actually the unique ID. So the unique ID is present in the first column. It is present in the first column of the spreadsheet. Let's run it. So you will get a message, script execution has started, please wait. Just click OK to close this. Just an error message. So once you get this, once the script is completed, you will get a message called script execution completed successfully. Just close it. And once the execution is completed, you will see three new files generated: the matches, no matches, and matches ID, no matches columns. So the matches will show all the matching records between both the files. So we have 10 records in data set file 1, 10 records in file 2, and total exact matches between file 1 and file 2 are 50%. You see the arrangement is, the records can be arranged in any fashion. So if let's say for example one employee ID 102 is present in both the files and all the data is same. So employee ID 102 is James. Let's take James. So James is here. Row number 2. And here, if row number 2 in the sense, we are not taking the headings in count. So the same James is present in. All the values are same for this employee. With employee ID 102, like 102 James. department find with the phone number and email address. The same data is present here. So this matches output file will show all the matching records, including the unique ID values along with the corresponding other values like names, phone numbers, departments, and email address. Let's open the second output file, which is no matches between file 1 and file 2. This is a straightforward missing record. Like, for example, here we see 104 record. Employee ID with 104, it is present in file 1 but not in file 2. Let's open that. So employee ID 104 is there in the first data set, which is yellow. You won't find anywhere in the second data set. So the employee ID itself is missing. So that will be marked here. And you will see in the summary result saying that we don't have one record which is actually present in the first data set and not in second. And the percentage of records for file one not in the second data set are 10%. Third one, this is something interesting. So here, if you see, the employee IDs are present, but the other values are not the same. So here, in this case, employee ID with 101, the department values are not matching. Let's go and see what is there for employee ID 101. So we have employee 101 here in the yellow data set and employee ID 101 in the green data set. So if we see closely, the department is mentioned as department 1 in the first yellow color data set, whereas it is department L, DEPL. So the text L is there. So that is a difference. The second, we'll take another example for employee ID 105. So there is a difference on phone number. Let's go and check. So there is a difference on phone number here, and 105 is here. So here, if you see closely, this is actually, it's not a zero, it's a capital O, whereas here it is actually zero. So that's the difference. So this third output file will show all the differences where the ID, the unique IDs are matching, but the other columns are not matching. So that's how we can do the in-depth data analysis on the spreadsheets, the in-depth data comparison on spreadsheets. If you want to run the, if you want to compare by taking the file 2 as a reference, by taking this one as a reference and comparing these yellow values, then you need to run the other script file, which is split and compare based on file 2, which will generate three new output files by taking the second data set as the reference. I'll just run so that you can see. So we have three more files, matches and the matches ID and no matches column. Both will show the same data, but the no matches will show a different data. Here you can see Catherine with employee ID 111 is present in the second data set but not in first data set. So she is there in the second data set, but you won't find the employee ID 111 in the first data set. So this way we are doing both A minus B and B minus A comparison on spreadsheets, and we can see the detailed results, and each result is specific to one group of records, like match, either it is a matches or it's a completely miss, or there is a record but other columns are not matching. So that's all I want to share on the spreadsheets comparison part, which is one of the utility in DATADECODER. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.